you know, all these issues, and I, as the curator, I've put together these films because of these issues that they foreground and the way these films speak to each other. But I also just want to say that there's some really, really strong filmmaking that's happening here. I want to congratulate K.P. Shashi for doing a film which is almost entirely consisting of just people sitting and talking, but the little things as a filmmaker that he does, the way he uses music, the way he uses abstract images, they don't seem forced. They don't seem like, oh, too much boring talking, now let's have an image. It doesn't work like that. Sometimes his choice of, during the shoot, during the edit, his choice of moving with a character before he comes and sits down, or reflections in water, or sudden cut to a Hindi film song, it works very well. It holds interest. And since this is a film festival, I just want to say that today, and even for me, I've seen these films separately, right? Over months and months, one day I saw Cyclist, one day. When I put them together like this, I think something's going to happen. But when I just think that there's some, that the ideas are very strong, and those of us who anyway care about them get even more happy that we get a chance to really share this. And those who of us who may not be so well informed do become more informed. But putting them together like this, I think it's also cinema that's happening. And I want to ask Shashi Kumar what you thought.
No, and actually, you know, I think you're absolutely wrong. You were very central to this discussion because censorship really began. You know, it shocked us so much with this kind of silencing by the killing of Safdar Hashmi.
This is a little more complicated, I think. You know, I mean, all of us can sit here and have a point of view. A lot of others can sit somewhere else and have exactly the opposite point of view, and it's not going to get us very far. I think the case of Salman was terrible. I think it is Islamophobia. It's even more ridiculous when somebody who says, I thank Hudud for what it did in Andhra because they did elect somebody I wanted to power. And the man is proceeded against under the same Information Technology Act, the same draconian act, and he's also under bail. So in this country, there's a freedom of expression problem. There's a problem of under trials, who are languishing in jail. And one third of those who are in jail are under trials. And there is a problem where although bail is a norm and jail is the exception, jail is a norm and bail is becoming exception. I think even in the case of Tarun Tejpal, I wrote about it, I think he deserved, I have no sympathy for the man, but the way he was consistently denied bail was terrible, I think. Just because it happened to be in Gujarat and on the plea that he is going to tamper with the evidence, you know. So I think one has to be equitable on this. Whereas if the Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu was in the same Parappana Agrahara jail, gets bail because that is the norm. Although it's a corruption case and there's a Supreme Court almost a kind of observation that bail should not be given in such cases. So obviously it is a very prejudiced kind of situation, and in a state like Kerala where one would expect that people are very aware, people are literate, literacy and common sense may not have much to do with each other. We've had repeated instances of this. We have had the ISRO case, spy case, in which I was involved. I mean, I had to get anticipatory bail at that time because we had said right from the outset on Asianet that this is a cooked up case. The state police, Smart Vijayan is the name of the person, who filed a case of defamation against me and against some others. And they were trying to just fix Mariam Rashida and Fauzia too again, because they happened to be from Maldives and they were there, and you build an entire case of espionage against them. The case you referred to obliquely in the film about Rajan, the Rajan murder case, it's a terrible case. It brought down a chief minister and the government, and it deservedly so. But it's a terrible case of torture and, of killing of the... So I'm not sure. I'm sure, and I don't want to overstate this. I'm not sure it's all religion. There is a problem. There is a real problem of injustice of the law and order mechanism going over the top, of exceeding its brief, of taking the law into their own hands. And there's no process of law in the strict sense of the term. To Kalpana's point about the Bombay riots, I would have thought the biggest film in India, the most ridiculous and terrible film made by Maniratnam was on the Bombay riots. All of us went to theaters and saw it, and it distorted the whole thing. There's another film, but I think a serious film. I haven't seen it, called the Black Friday, on the Bombay riots as well. So I think films are being made on each of these situations in different ways, but how they interpret it, it becomes a big problem. Madani's case, I think it's obviously a case of both political and religious kind of victimization. You know, it's a combination of the two. If he was not the leader of the PDP, perhaps they would not have gone after him as he was. Because it became necessary to fix the map.
A Muslim spiritual leader
who commanded such a big following. So it is a terrible, terrible thing. And I think the movement really should be against people languishing in jails without trial in a time frame, for years and years on end. And if this is happening in visible states, articulate states like Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, imagine what is happening in states like Bihar, UP, or Uttar Pradesh, or Orissa. We don't know, and we are not even shocked because we don't know. You can imagine the number of people. If one third of them are in jail, you can imagine each of them is a tragedy. Is a terrible story.
My name is Tavita. I just wanted to ask you with regard to the case where Madani, where we're talking about Islamophobia. Kamal also, the filmmaker Kamal also mentioned that Madani by default is also a hero in some other way in the polity of Kerala. I was just wondering if one could talk a little about this dichotomy of Madani's character as a hero somewhere at the same time, you know, being usurped into the mainstream as a hero, as a Muslim hero, while at the same time, you know, his position being, I believe he said that his position is being used by people, and the fanfare with when he was released is actually not really fanfare, but more counterproductive. I just wanted to.
This was after the Coimbatore blast.
Immediately after the Coimbatore blast.
This was when he was acquitted.
Well, Safdar, there's little to say. I was, in fact, quite surprised, pleasantly, though, that this film is being shown in a festival. What is surprising is this year, Safdar is suddenly in demand in various festivals, and I don't know why. It's just one of those funny things. The film was made way back in the 80s, and it's about a friend and a cultural activist and a very lovely person called Safdar Hashmi, who was killed by Congress goons because of his activities, which were secular, against tyrannies of all sorts. And the film was made very quickly after that. So it was not a film on which I could spend too much time. It was made within 2 weeks after he was killed. And there's an organization called Sahmat, which is now perpetuating the memory of Safdar Hashmi. So it's a film as a friend, as someone I knew well, and someone I was moving with quite closely. And so it has footage ranging from VHS, very bad footage, to what we shot. And it was shot on high band in those days. UHS, you know, we had only high band format to shoot. So it's not the best in terms of resolution. I'm not even sure how it's going to look. I haven't seen it myself for a long time. Grainy. Yeah, so it must be grainy. So you must be prepared for that. It's an oldish kind of film. It's a different kind of, it's again the manifestation of the same intolerance, the refusal to see the other point of view, and what the those with clout, with muscle, do to you if you go against what they think is what should be.
Thanks a lot, everyone. We'll go back to watching the film because that's. But just as a last point, I mean, it just occurred to me when you were speaking that I don't think the arrests or, you know, there have been any convictions in that, in the Safdar case. So impunity rules, you know, even in this case, and it will in several others. So thank you, both of you.
सुंदर सुहाग से टाटा मुझे किसान ने फिर खेत से एक दिन मंडी में लाके छोड़ दिया खेत से एक दिन दिल्ली को रजपीठ मंडी में लाके छोड़ दिया खेत से एक दिन ए कहेंगे हिंदुस्तानी रहेगा हिंदुस्तान ए कहेंगे हिंदुस्तानी रहेगा हिंदुस्तान
Those of you know that he was a committed left. He belonged to the Communist Party of India, Marxist. He was promoting their cultural activities. And Molloy Shree carries on with the street theatre work now, Molloy Shree Hashmi. And you might have noticed many people who look a lot young there, younger there, including Prakash Karat, V.P. Singh, Bhisham Sahani. Of course, you could recognize some of the others there, Shabana Azmi and so on. So.
I just wanted to say that I really should thank you for making that film, because it must have been so difficult to make so soon after he died. Yeah. But you have amazing footage, and you know, after all these years, one really gets a sense of what Safdar was and what he could have been. So it's really, thanks so much for that. That's really something.
Well, I just remembered my making the film was nothing, because Moyaleshwari, who's doing that play, she did that play immediately after his death, you know, just after his cremation, or you know, she did that play. So they were very determined that they're not going to be deterred by this any which way, no mourning, you know. So we were all in that kind of a mood. So it was actually kind of invigorating us more than, I mean, as much as saddening, I think, people around at that time.